Pettigate, baker's man. Good morning, madam. I'm a psychiatrist.
You look like a milkman to me.
Good. I'm in fact dressed as a milkman. You spotted that. Well done.
Go away.
Now then, madam, I'm going to show you three numbers, and I want you to tell me if you see any similarity between them.
They're all number three.
No, try again.
They're all number three?
No, they're all number three. Right, now, I'm going to say a word, and I want you to say the first thing that comes into your head. How many pints do you want?
Three?
Yogurt?
No.
Cream?
No.
Eggs?
No.
Right, well, you're quite clearly suffering from a repressive libido complex, probably the result of a product of an unhappy childhood coupled with acute insecurity in adolescence, which has resulted in an attenuation of the libido complex.
You are a bloody milkman!
Don't you shout at me, madam! Don't come that tone! Now then, I must ask you to accompany me down to the dairy and do some aptitude tests.
I've got better things to do than come down to the dairy.
Mrs. Ratbag, if you don't mind me saying so, you're badly in need of an expensive course of psychiatric treatment. Now, I'm not going to say a trip to our dairy will cure you, but it will give hundreds of lower-paid workers a good laugh.
All right, but how am I going to get home?
I'll run you there and back on my psychiatrist float.
All right.
What are all those?
They're case histories.
Oh, good morning. I'm afraid our regular psychiatrist hasn't come round this morning, and I've got an ego block, which is in turn making my wife overassertive and getting us both in a state of depressive neurosis.
Oh, I see. So who's your regular, sir?
Jersey Cream psychiatrist.
Oh, yes, I know them. Right, well, what's your job, then?
I'm a doctor.
Didn't I see you just now under a Scotsman?
Yes, but I am a doctor. Actually, I'm a gynecologist, but that was my lunch hour.
What does this remind you of?
2 pints of cream.
Right. Well, I should definitely say you were suffering from severe personality disorder, sir, sublimating itself in a lactic obsession, which could get worse depending on how much money you've got.
Yes, I see. And a pot of yogurt, please.
I'd like to take this opportunity of complaining about the way in which these shows are continually portraying psychiatrists who make pat diagnoses of patients' problems without first obtaining their full medical history.
Mind you, that's just a pat diagnosis made without first obtaining your full medical history.
I feel the time has come to complain about people who make rash complaints without first making sure that those complaints are justified. Are you referring to me? Not necessarily. However, I would like to point out that the Balpa spokesman was wearing the British Psychiatric Association Dinner Dance Club cufflinks.
Yes, I noticed that too.
These are not British Psychiatric Association Dinner Dance Club cufflinks.
Sorry.
They are, in fact, a British Sugar Corporation Gilbert and Sullivan Society cufflinks. It's, in fact, a sort of in-joke with us lads here at Balpa. I think the last speaker should have checked his facts before making his own rash complaint.
Yeah, that'll teach him.
However, I would just like to add a complaint about shows which have too many complaints in them, as they get very tedious for the average viewer.
I'd like to complain about people who hold things up by complaining about people complaining. It's about time something was done about it.
Will you take Mrs. Pym to see Dr. Cream, please?
Oh, sorry for me, Doctor. Walk this way, please.
Oh, if I could walk that way, I would...
Mrs. Pym to see you, Dr. Cream.
Oh, yes, I just want another 5 minutes with Audrey. Could you show Mrs. Pym into the waiting room, please?
Yes, Doctor.
Right. Audrey, when did you first start thinking you were...
Jeez, Mr. Belford.
Ha ha ha! filthy. Your great legs is all swollen.
Oh! Your legs are all swollen.